What's up? How y'all doing? How are you guys? So I got another episode for the LS. So obviously we're getting ready to do the LOJ stuff as we've been talking about. For the full swap, we got our trans ready and now we got our engine. And so we took the manifolds off, turbo kit, everything. The turbo's off. But now we're gonna go ahead and put a brand new water pump that we got on it. The water pump that came on the motor was pretty much toasted. It was no good. I wasn't gonna run it anyways. All this stuff is like not crazy expensive, so it's worth to just do it while the motor's out and not have to worry about it later, rather to later in the car having to change all the stuff out. So why not? So I got a AC Delco truck water pump. The truck one's perfect. We have our new Gates belt. We got an AC Delco thermostat housing. And then we got an AC Delco tensioner. Some nice ARP part number for all you guys. Normal hex style bolts. And then our OEM bolts. Our AC Delco water pump came with all new gaskets. The water pump already has this gasket, but we'll use this one as well. Or the thermostat housing, I mean. But pretty straight simple, so you obviously have to take your old water pump off. The ports are here. I had them taped off so nothing gets in. And I don't know why whoever painted this motor painted the inside. Kind of shitty job, but anyways, with a gasket scraper, you guys want to get all these surfaces nice and flat and clean. I already did it once. I'm going to go over it one more time on both sides. Get it nice and clean. And then we're going to go ahead and throw on our water pump first. Alright, so we cleaned the surfaces up very nicely. It's very smooth. If you guys don't have this, this is a must have. This is like a Lysol tool. I don't know the part number for it, but it's these like carbide like scrapers or whatever they call them. Not really sure exactly what they call them, but this thing was sick. So easy. Just clean off the gaskets. Comes in a two-pack with the bigger head too. But pretty much got the area where the gasket's seating nice and clean. This one too. These are not, like your nail doesn't get caught. It's just this is how the metal looks. But yeah, now you want to clean this area off so we can begin installing our water pump. Alright, so for the style water pump that we have, you guys see how there's that rubber indentation. This one, the thermostat pretty much goes ahead and comes out of this. So what we're going to do with this style, if you have this, you need to use this gasket. If yours doesn't have that little indentation, then you just put the new O-ring on. And then we have our gaskets for the water pump. And let me check that they line up good. So we have our ARP hardware out of the box now, some anti-seize, and pretty much you can go ahead and mount this up. For good practice, you don't need to, but you can apply some small amount of RTV, just a small amount, and just rub it in with your finger and do the to gasket, but don't do a crazy amount. You don't need to really do this. But yeah, that's what we'll do. So the bolts for the water pump, 1, 2, 3, 6. So pretty easy. I'll throw that on and then we'll catch up after this. All right, so just like that, we have our ARP hardware on. Our pump on, ceiling looks perfect on both sides, very very nice. The bottom side looks good. Alright, so now that this is torqued down to 11 foot pounds and to 22 foot pounds, we're good to go. Water pump's installed. So yeah, pretty much next we're gonna install the thermostat with to the thermostat housing, turn our tensioner pulley, and we're good to go. Alright, so thermostat housing, as you guys can tell, there's a little indentation right here. You're gonna want to make sure the gasket is seated nice and good all the way around. And we have this paper gasket thing too, it says we need to use, so we're gonna use. And if you're using a truck thermostat, you'll reuse this and not the gasket. But just for safe measures, same thing, a little bit of RTV just around the surface and on the gasket. And then NTCs or ARP bolts, these it says just hand tight, like wrist tight, so that's what we'll do. And pretty much just right here, there's no wrong way to put it, the thermostat housing. needs to be facing this way, so yeah, looks good. All right, so that's our thermostat housing installed now with our ARP hardware. I read online these are the torque pounds for like 6 or 7 foot-pounds. Don't go crazy though, you don't want to strip it. But yeah, we got it in. Nice, so now all that remains is our tensioner. And that uses these two long bolts and the short bolt. The long bolts go here, short bolt goes here. All right, tensioner's installed, all three bolts. Nicely fitted, torqued to 37 foot-pounds. Set to go. Now with the paint pen, I'm gonna mark all the hardware. So later we can check in the future to make sure it didn't move, but yeah, this is it. Came out very nice. Very happy, all new stuff. Now we don't have to worry about any of it. Anyways, hope this video helps out somebody who's doing an LS swap or LS work or anything like that. Anyways, thanks for watching. Peace.